10th annual Mayor's Trophy game called A Celebration of Cricket, which takes place at Sunnybrook Park, just only a couple of days away. Now, SEMA Canada's Celebration of Cricket is an award-winning event which showcases cricket for SEMA's members, their families and friends, and for the wider community. We are very happy to have Harold Baird and his deputy president, Mr. Gulzari Babur, who is also making the trip with him to Canada this time. But Harold, I want to welcome you to Canada and first of all congratulate you on your election to the presidency of SEMA, which happened only a few weeks ago.
Yes, the 4th of June, and thank you very much for the warm congratulations. Very pleased.
You've been to Canada before?
Yes, I have been once with family visit and last year for the cricket tournament at for the Mayor's Trophy. And so I enjoyed it so much I've come back.
Well, we're really happy that you could, you know, come in here to do the thing.
But it's really the opportunity that it gives to young people to play and play the game of cricket, which we in SEMA are very much support, because we think the disciplines of cricket and playing the game right in an ethical way is in line with our own code of practice of ethics and playing business in the right kind of way.
Now, we're always very happy here at ATN to welcome you and the various presidents of SEMA that have come here in the past, because every year we get to interview somebody new, because I think your term of office is it 2 years or 1 year?
One year.
1 year.
You serve as a deputy and then as president and then as immediate past president, so yes. Gulzari Babur will follow me next year.
Yes, and so yes, we've seen a succession of presidents of SEMA come by, and we've had a very fine time with all of them. Now this year, like every year, the SEMA Mayor's Trophy game is a distinguished event. It's, you know, a lot of good stuff goes on, and something special happens every year. This year it's extremely special because now this year we've got a new mayor.
Mayor Ford.
Yes, and, Mr. Rob Ford.
He has been very generous with his time and his support. And I understand that perhaps cricket's not his first love in sporting world, but he has been generous with his time. And in fact, I would like to express my thanks to him for that generous support right here.
I know His Worship Mayor Ford is a sports person as well, and he'll catch on to cricket.
Absolutely.
Soon enough.
We hope that the cricket will bowl him over.
Yes, very good, very good. Also this year, we'll have representatives from both the federal and provincial governments.
Yes, the Minister of Finance is joining us. And in fact, it just demonstrates how much they see the benefit of cricket and the benefit of playing and driving business in a correct way. And in fact, I believe that the two match. And don't we have three levels of government? The municipal and the
Federal Minister of Finance, Mr. Jim Flaherty, and Member of the Provincial Parliament, Christine Elliott.
From what I've read and what the SEMA Canada Committee have told me, they're all very supportive, and that's tremendous, and in fact speaks highly of the SEMA Canada Regional Board for their organisational ability and their encouragement to people to participate. And there are two teams of to start the day rolling of chief executives from the public sector section and a team from the private sector chief executives who will play in the first. And then we have the young persons teams that will go. And it's a tremendous day of full of excitement and good family fun.
Well, you said it yourself. SEMA Canada has done a tremendous job of promoting this game, and we see people coming out on the cricket field that we wouldn't ordinarily have seen. And then the more that this happens, the more we learn that there are many CEOs and people in other positions here who come from a cricket background.
And enjoy the cricket. Yes. I myself didn't play very much cricket. I played when I was a member of a scout troop in Northern Ireland many years ago, too many years, and I suppose in a sense my first love is rugby. But I enjoy the cricket, and I've certainly enjoyed the success Ireland have had in cricket, even as a small nation And their success was quite good. And of course, I always watch out how England are playing.
Well, so you must have kept an eye on both England and Ireland during the last World Cup.
I did, and there was great excitement, and Ireland looked like going places, and then it didn't work quite. But, you know, we don't have a large number to select from, so it is difficult. But England were good, and I suppose there was disappointment after them winning the Ashes that they weren't more successful. But it was good for
It was all good cricket, though.
Particularly for India and, of course, Sri Lanka, who were there in the final with them.
Well, you've been to the Mayor's Cup before.
Yes.
And you've seen the fun that happens here.
And even the fun on the occasions when the rain was on.
Yes.
And I think we were accused of bringing that with us from England, the rain.
Now, Harold, you've been here to the Mayor's Trophy game before, so you know how much fun and excitement there is there at the game.
A tremendous day, and in fact, the commentary that's given during the game is, in fact, not just fun, but very amusing. And there's good. The last year, I enjoyed so much the two commentators who were complimenting one another.
And how well they were doing.
And so, in fact, they made the game extremely exciting and very enjoyable. Super. Yeah.
For our viewers watching this who may not have been to the game before, we've got a number of teams who represent the media in this city and both the public and the private sectors, and the chief executive officers and other personnel from these industries and from the media. They come out and they play in a fun-filled fashion, but they're always also very competitive.
Oh, absolutely. Each team wants to win, and they take it on the day. They take it very seriously.
It's a real celebration.
It's a real celebration, and there's refreshments, lots of.
But there's a lot of giveaways too.
Yes.
I mean, and there's generally speaking, there's free pizza and stuff. So
free pizzas, yeah. And even some free beer.
Free beer, you say? Now.
There.
Free beer. What sort of reports do you get back at headquarters about this event? If you can share that with us.
Yes, we get that the game of cricket represents lots of the good things about life, the disciplines and the ethics that's necessary. And we have been tremendously impressed by the amount of coverage this gets, by the way that it is supported, and the way that the SEMA and the cricket and the Mayor's Trophy has come into being. And it works extremely well, and we do have other things that we run. We have a global business challenge, which the finals will be in Chengdu in China in July, and it's good, but it's different because it's all about a business game. Mm-hmm. This is a sporting game, but played by the same kind of rules as the business game. And everybody learns. And of course, this leads to us bringing the team that comes across and plays a series in the tour. We call it the Cricket Across the Pond.
Across the Pond.
And
that's a great
tremendous
initiative.
Because those young people who are learning the skills, and there's skills that will stand them all their life, and perhaps as they hopefully go on to be business leaders. And they have the opportunity to play over a period of 10 days. A number of teams, and even this year, one of the events in their calendar is to go to the Lord's Cricket Ground.
Lord's, yes.
Which is tremendously exciting if you play the game of cricket to get there for a visit, and I hope to join them when they visit the Lord's Cricket Ground. I want to see it as well. I haven't been there before.
that's a wonderful initiative for the young men who play cricket,
cricket.
In the school, from the schools.
And it's selected. It's a competition to get the teams.
To get there, yes.
And it will add to the submission that they have to put in, is good for their CVs, and we hope that it leads to them having a good, exciting business career. And some of those that come on the cricket come from a disadvantaged background. So that is another of the reasons why we think that's okay.
We'll have to take a short break now, Harold. We'll be right back. We're talking with Harold Baird, president of SEMA. Harold Baird is here for the SEMA Canada's Mayor's Trophy Celebration of Cricket. What special duties you have to perform at the game?
Oh, I get to give out the prizes at the end of the day, present and be available for some photographs that will be taken, and to cheer on some of the team, particularly the junior team that has been selected from after following the competition.
So that's what you need to do.
Now,
and for you, it's a whole lot of fun. And of course, you've got your deputy president with you here this year,
Rosario
Barber, and he's going to have to help you do some of this.
He has to assist, because there's quite a number of cups and challenges and various team awards.
Three trophies, I think.
That's right.
That the teams are playing for.
We share the duty of presenting the trophies at the end of the day, and expressing our thanks, of course, particularly to Mayor Ford for his support, and to the SEMA Canada board led by Amal this time. And of course, that reminds me very much that Kentish Tifazara, we have 183,000 members and students around the world, in fact in 208 countries. I think that speaks volumes that we have awarded Kentish a silver medal. We do not award very many silver medals, and it's because of the tremendous leadership that he has given over 15 years in driving the SEMA Canada board and bringing it forward. And he has provided the guidance and direction that has turned the SEMA Mayor's Trophy from a small event into a very large event and a very successful event, in conjunction, obviously, the Mayor and our sponsors of the event.
You're talking, of course, about Kentish Tifazara.
Yes.
Who was president of SEMA Canada for the last 15 years.
15 years, yes.
And the awards that you mentioned are the two ICC, the International Cricket Council Awards,
yes,
that were given to SEMA Canada for this same Mayor's Trophy celebration of cricket,
yes,
as top promotion events for cricket.
That's
wonderful,
absolutely
achievement.
A wonderful achievement. But he's a gentleman, he's a man who gives of his time, not just for SEMA and not just to the cricket, but to many charities. He's a non-executive director and honorary member of quite a number of charities, and gives his tremendous skill as a management accountant.
Give this award to Kentish tonight because
in the Marriott Hotel, because he had been invited but due to work commitments was unable to attend the annual general meeting in London.
To get this done in London.
To receive his award. So it's my pleasure to make that presentation this evening.
Well, that's wonderful. We congratulate Kentish tremendously on this award. Harold, the SEMA globally, you've entered into a partnership agreement with the American Institute of Certified Public Accountants. How significant is this?
This is the most significant event since we received our Royal Charter back in the 70s. It brings together SEMA, who are the largest body of management accountants, meaning that we are the largest body of accountants being training, where our training is fully within business, together with the AICPAs, who have 140,000 members who work in business. This, with our new chartered global management accountant, CGMA, will provide a global passport. It will give us the resources and thought leadership to develop the science of management accounting, and to continue the continual research that's used to set our examination syllabus and the examinations, thereby making it fit for purpose for management accounting and driving the success of business. And this, so it will be tremendous. It will have provide, as I said, a global passport, and in many, many countries, but obviously the Americas, Europe, Asia, Australia, and Africa, we all covered. And where in the countries where SEMA are strongest, that will be tremendous. Many of those travel all over the world to do the work. And of course, coupled with the countries in the world where the AICPA are strong as well as in, obviously in America.
How does CIMA differ, let's say, the designation that is, differ from maybe a CMA?
Well,
those
who work in management accountant tend to be working in business, setting and identifying how the business should be driven, how the business will be achieve success, the risk management, setting strategies that add value to for the company, whereas those who would do the CA would be more focused on presenting the audit and tax side and reporting what has happened after the event. We are very much about driving the business forward and identifying the way forward.
Harold, is the tenure of presidency of CIMA, is it too short? I mean, how much can you do in a year? What plans have you got, you know, for CIMA over this next year?
Well, my theme has been to drive partnership. We've concentrated for the last 2 years, first in getting and driving our relevance and setting, achieving of our aims, and through our research, getting sustainability. And I want to drive us with through improve and build on that with partnership and engagement. Can you do very much? Well, it's not a 1 year. You work as over a 4 year period in conjunction with a team, and in fact partnership, and as it is in management accounting, because all those who are in business are working as a team, be it with the other senior managers in their company or other directors, and in CIMA and in our CIMA council. It's the continuity that we work with, work in conjunction with our senior management team and a very significant number of staff who are excellent.
Well, this is all very serious stuff, of course, and you know, in some quarters, I say in some quarters, accountants tend to be considered to be very staid, you know, and maybe stoic and not having too much fun and just the bean counters and stuff. But here, perfect example where accountants are just, you know, getting us all ready for fun.
We tend to think that it's the bean counters are those who are counting up and reporting what had happened. We want to be seen as the ones that are driving the business forward. And, you know, I think if you have the bean counter and you are going on holidays, the bean counter would take all the photographs and do the diary, and when you returned, they would give you a nice report of where you had been.
This festival of cricket, you know, and the Mayor's Trophy is just fantastic. It's a whole lot of fun.
The Canadian MAs are support and, in fact, sponsor our event. So, and we have a mutual understanding agreement with them. So we recognise them as being a high calibre examination and qualification, as they recognise us in the same way.
You'll see people playing this game that you wouldn't normally think.
Some senior people come and enjoy it, so it's good.
The other thing is that we need to just make sure that we give some semblance of the itinerary for the day, just so that we understand.
We start at 9 a.m. with some formalities and presentations and introductions, and then we have the opening game as the executives, the CEOs.
The mayor's 11 against the CEOs.
Yes, that's great. So that one is very.
And then the competition
really starts, and it's on a knockout basis of 10 overs each team, and then it goes to a final, which will probably be 4 p.m., 4 to 5, and that's when it's really exciting.
Yes, and there's the PA system goes, there's commentaries, there's all kinds of music, there's noise.
There's noise and refreshments, and a good day is had by all. So it's really a fun day, and coming from Ireland, I thoroughly enjoy it.
Still in practice, or is being president of CIMA as a full-time job?
It's not quite a full-time job, but it's every week, and because I at some distance away, so for this year, other partners have taken over from me, and I have this 12 months off to concentrate on CIMA.
Well, Harold, in the minute that we have left, if you wanted to say anything else to our viewers or to SEMA Canada, just please do so.
Well, I would, first and foremost, I would thank the SEMA Canada Regional Board for their support. I thank Mayor Ford for his support, enthusiastic support. And I would thank our sponsors on the day, of which there are quite a number, too many for me just to over. And I thank your television channel for screening this interview. I'm very pleased.
It's our pleasure entirely.
Thank you, Candy.
I'm speaking with Harold Baird, President of SEMA, regarding the Mayor's Trophy celebration of cricket.